Hello everyone. In this video you will see how I create a retro poster with a duotone effect. We're going to open Photoshop with a poster format and we're going to start importing our images. We're going to merge the two images to recover the foreground of the first image. To do this, we will use a brush over a mask and with a Ctrl plus T, we will deform our mask to give it the shape we want. Once the two images are roughly in position, we will continue to import our images. For our main subject, we will quickly crop our image with a selection tool, in Selection, then Subject. This will automatically select the main subject of our image. Then we will apply a mask to it and copy our layer and paste it directly onto our poster. Once positioned, we will be able to rework our image and erase the details that do not bother. Once repositioned, we will import our flower image. With the magic wand tool, we can directly select the background of our image to recover only the white. Then, with the quick selection tool, I'm going to correct the areas that were not selected beforehand. I will invert my selection, apply a mask and copy and paste my flower directly onto my poster. With Ctrl plus T, and then by pressing the Ctrl key and clicking and moving my mouse, I can directly deform my selection. This will allow me to rework the perspective of my flower so that it fits better. Then with the rectangle tool, I will create a rectangular shape the size of my poster. To add an outline to our poster, in the options of my rectangle, I will apply a transparent background and a white outline. We're going to be able to increase its thickness right here and place our frame correctly. We will place it under our main subject to give a volume effect to our poster. We are going to crop our background image a little more and simply replace our main elements. We will be able to add several graphic elements to compose our poster. This is the longest part. Here we go. We'll start by adding a text that I composed on Adobe Illustrator. It's a custom font that I'll simply copy and paste onto our poster. In the Filter tab, I open a filter called Fluidity. Here I will be able to manually distort my typography with the clockwise swirl and by choosing a large enough brush size and not too much pressure. I want to be able to left-click and move my mouse to distort my typography quickly. Once I'm satisfied, I validate and here is our deformation. It is simple and non-destructive on our layers and we can remove and put back our effect directly on our layer. I'm going to add a detail here because I think it's empty. We'll fill it in by adding a graphic element. I'm going to import a flower directly and put it here. I'm going to convert it into a dynamic object. The same as for our text with fluidity. I'm going to deform it manually then validate. I will convert the layer back into a dynamic object and with a Ctrl plus T, I will replace it and deform it to place it correctly. I will do the same for the text by selecting my two layers and pressing Ctrl. I'll be able to come in and distort the typography to place it better. Then it will move my typography behind the main element and we'll come back to that later. We will concentrate on importing graphic elements. With the rectangle tool, I'm going to apply a transparent background and an outline and create an area at this level that I'll place under my main element. I'm going to take advantage of this to lock it, so that it is no longer selectable. From now on, we'll be able to start importing graphic elements inside my rectangle. I intend to import several graphic elements into my rectangle. To do this, I am going to do a left-click control directly on the thumbnail of my layer. Then I will create a new group, then apply this mask to this group. This will create a mask directly in my group and all the objects I import into it will be masked. So for example, if I import a rectangle inside, you can see that it is masked by the mask of my group. On my mask and with a brush, I'm going to erase the areas of my rectangle that I dragged into my layer so that I can see my graphics better. Then we will continue the import within our layer group. So we're going to add some detail to our background. To do this, I've grabbed some liquid, very abstract topography. Once I've typed my text, I'll simply copy and paste it into the background and move it around. I will create a dynamic object out of it, and by double-clicking on my layer, I will be able to access the layer style. Here in my blend option, I'm going to reduce the opacity of the background to 0. And in outline, add an outline to my shape, which will allow me to make visible only the outline of my dynamic object, and I will be able to place it, adjust it as I wish. I'm going to duplicate my selection, deactivate the outline effect, increase my background a little bit so that we can detach our background a little bit, and I'm going to put everything in the back so that it's only visible on the top part of my image. We're going to continue with the import of details on my poster. We're going to convert our flower and our text into dynamic objects, duplicate the selection and place our text a little bit lower on the layer below. We will reduce the background to 0, and by double-clicking on it, we will add a color and apply an outline. We will choose an outer outline and thicken it a little. We're going to remove the color overlay to add some detail to the topography and the drop shadow that we've created on this topography. We're going to import a texture here that we're going to copy and paste directly and right-click on the layer and create a clipping mask inside. We can't see it because the image is black. We're going to overlay a white color on it and that's it. This will lighten the shadow of our text and add some detail. We're going to add our trademark directly onto our flower because it looks a bit empty. Once we have replaced all our elements as we wish, we can move on. Our duotone effect and adding textures to make our posture more realistic. For our duotone effect, we can do this simply by going to settings. If you don't have the settings option in window, just press settings. Inside there will be the option gradient transfer curve. Then in properties, the gradient we want to apply will appear. We will put a light color on one side and a darker color on the other. This will transform all our shapes and colors to the color base of the gradient we have chosen. So here blue and beige. But you can see that some elements stand out more than others, so we're going to detach them from each other for a better readability of the poster. First, I'm going to add a white outline to the flower. And for the mannequin, we will add an external light. In settings, we can add some color corrections. So here with contrast, luminosity, and by creating a clipping mask, we will be able to make the dress of our mannequin stand out a little more. The same goes for our flower so that it is more visible with the level option. We add a clipping mask on our flower. We will be able to add a bit of black to the other image, which will darken it and make it more present. The same goes for our landscape background, contrast, and luminosity. We're going to accentuate our background image a bit. Simply with a very wide brush and a zero hardness. I'm going to make the sky stand out a bit more by painting black inside and creating a clipping mask in our landscape, which will create a sort of gradient. In general, I'm going to rework the luminosity and contrast of my image and we'll be able to add textures to make our poster much more realistic. I'm going to import textures directly. The first texture I'm going to import, I'm going to place it on top of all my layers, and it's going to be a distorted and worn paper texture that we're going to place in center. we will apply a darker color blending mode to it. This will add a little more character to our image and realism. I'm going to add a second texture to which I'm going to apply the overlay blend mode. Here, it is a wear texture placed on top of it which will add a little more grain and detail to our image. We will duplicate the layer on top and double-click to apply a black and white gradient with a reflective style. Once our composition is ready and we have adjusted all the details we want, we will be able to directly override all our layers, then convert it into a dynamic object. Thus, in Filters and Raw Camera Filters, we can rework the colors of our poster as we wish. Once satisfied, all we have to do is validate. The filter will be applied and it will be non-destructive because it is a dynamic filter. And now you know how to create a retro poster with a duotone effect easily. Don't forget to leave a comment, a blue thumb, and above all to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss my next videos. See you next time.